And here is the Writer's Almanac for Sunday. It's the 21st of February, 2021. The first issue of the New Yorker magazine, published on this date, 1925, edited by Harold Ross, founded by him and his wife Jane Grant, a magazine not edited for the old lady in Dubuque. It's the birthday of the novelist David Foster Wallace, born Ithaca, New York, 1962, author of the 1,079-page novel Infinite Jest, came out in 1996, about a former pop singer, Johnny Gentle, who is the American president, title referring to a film that terrorists are trying to steal because it's rumored that to watch the film gives the watcher such joy that the joy becomes fatal. It's the birthday of W.H. Auden, the poet, born in York, England, 1907, emigrated to America. A prolific writer, published over 400 poems in his lifetime, wrote librettos, film scripts, criticism. His writing habits were simple. Auden woke up, he had strong coffee, toast for breakfast, had a few cigarettes, worked the crossword puzzle in the New York Times, read the obituaries, and then sat down and got to work. It was on this day, 1848, the best-selling political pamphlet of all time was first published, The Communist Manifesto by Marx and Engels. It's the birthday of Anais Nin, born in Noailles, France, in 1903, whose diaries she began to publish in the mid-1960s, and the writer Ha Jin, born in Liaoning Province in China, 1956. His books include Under the Red Flag, Waiting, and A Map of Betrayal. Here's a poem for today, a little music hall verse from England in the mid-19th century by Harry Clifton, entitled Polly Perkins. I am a broken-hearted milkman, in grief I'm arrayed, through keeping of the company of a young servant maid who lived on board and wages the house to keep clean in a gentleman's family near Paddington Green. She was as beautiful as a butterfly and as proud as a queen, was pretty little Polly Perkins of Paddington Green. She'd an ankle like an antelope and a step like a deer, a voice like a blackbird so mellow and clear. Her hair hung in ringlets so beautiful and long. I thought that she loved me, but I found I was wrong. When I'd rattle in a morning and cry, "Milk below!" at the sound of my milk cans, her face she would show, with a smile upon her countenance and a laugh in her eye. If I thought she'd have loved me, I'd have laid down to die. When I asked her to marry me, she said, "Oh, what stuff," and told me to drop it, for she'd had quite enough of my nonsense. At the same time, I'd been very kind, but to marry a milkman she didn't feel inclined. Oh, the man that has me must have silver and gold, a chariot to ride in and be handsome and bold. His hair must be curly as any watch spring, and his whiskers as big as a brush for clothing. The words that she uttered went straight through my heart. I sobbed and I sighed, and straight did depart, with a tear on my eyelid as big as a bean, bidding goodbye to Polly and Paddington Green. In 6 months she married, this hard-hearted girl, but it was not a viscount, and it was not an earl. It was not a baronite, but a shade or two wuss. It was a bow-legged conductor of a two-penny bus. A music hall verse by Harry Clifton about pretty little Polly Perkins of Paddington Green. That's the Writer's Almanac for Sunday, February the 21st, funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.